हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू चैप्टर 16, वाटर अ प्रेशियस रिसोर्स। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डिप्लीशन ऑफ वाटर एंड वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट वेरियस फैक्टर्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर डिप्लीशन ऑफ वाटर टेबल। लेट अस नाउ डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ वाटर। The distribution of water over the globe is quite uneven due to a number of factors. Some places have good amount of rain and are water rich. On the other hand, there are deserts which have scanty rainfall. So here we are told that the distribution of water across the earth is not even due to different factors such as rainfall and climatic conditions. Some places have high amount of water while others face scarcity of water. India is a vast country and rainfall is not the same everywhere. Some regions have excessive rains while some others have very little rainfall. Excessive rains cause floods, whereas the absence of rains results in droughts. Therefore, some regions in our country may have floods while others may suffer from droughts at the same time. So we all know that India is a vast country, बहुत बड़ी country है और यहाँ पर हर एक state में equally rainfall नहीं मिलता। ऐसे regions है जहाँ पर rainfall जो है वो बहुत low है। For example, places like Rajasthan get very low rainfall and hence they have less water. On the other hand, places like Meghalaya, they receive high rainfall and have high amount of water. So hence there can be times when one part of India faces floods while the other is suffering from drought like condition. Activity 16.5. Given here is the rainfall map of India, figure 16.8. It gives the average annual rainfall in different regions of our country. Locate on the map the place you live in. Are you blessed with sufficient rainfall? Is there sufficient water available in your area throughout the year? It may be possible that we are living in an area where there is sufficient rainfall, yet there is shortage of water. Can we attribute this to mismanagement of water resources? You need to perform this activity on your own. All you need to do is to locate the area you live in on the map. Next, you need to see the shade of the color in that area. For example, the color near West Bengal and Southern India are dark, while the color near Rajasthan and Gujarat, they are lighter in shade. Iska matlab kya hai? Here you are given rainfall in centimeter. If the shade is darker, that means that particular area receives heavy rainfall, and if the shade is light, then that means there is low rainfall in that particular region. So you need to locate your area, the area you live in, on this map, and you need to check the annual rainfall in the area you live in. Here in this paragraph, we are told that even if people are living in a region where the rainfall is sufficient, they still face shortage of water. So why does this happen? Is it because of the mismanagement of water resources? That is, the water we get due to rainfall should be managed properly. If it is not managed properly, then there can be a chance of shortage of water even if we are receiving sufficient rainfall. So with this, let us discuss the next topic, water management. You have read in class 6 that in many places a regular supply of water is provided by a well-planned pipe system. When the civic authorities supply water through pipes, not all of it may reach the destination. You might have seen water supply pipes leaking and a lot of water gushing out of the pipes. It is the responsibility of the civic authorities to prevent such wastage of precious water. So no matter whether a place receives high rainfall or low rainfall, water management is necessary to ensure that everyone gets access to an adequate amount of water, that is to a sufficient amount of water. So generally, the civic authorities of a region are responsible for the supply of water in that area. So they use a well-structured pipeline system to deliver water to every house and building of the locality. Not only this, it is also a responsibility of civic authorities to prevent wastage of water and check if supply of water is adequate or not. तो जो कभी कभी आप लोगों ने देखा होगा कि पाइप्स लीक हो रहे हैं, उसमें से पानी जो है वो लीक होके काफ़ी सारा पानी वेस्ट हो रहा है. सो इट इज़ आवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एंड इट इज़ ऑल्सो द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द सिविक अथॉरिटीज टू चेक दैट द प्रेशियस वाटर इज नॉट वेस्टेड. सो वी मस्ट प्रिवेंट द वेस्टेज ऑफ वाटर. मिसमैनेजमेंट ऑफ वेस्टेज में टेक प्लेस एट अ लेवल ऑफ इंडिविजुअल्स ऑल्सो. All of us, knowingly or unknowingly, waste water while brushing teeth, shaving, bathing, washing, and during many other activities. Leaking taps is another source of huge water wastage. We waste water as though we do not need water the next time. We know that management of water is necessary and it is our responsibility to prevent wastage of water. During our everyday activities like brushing teeth, what happens is sometimes we brush, while brushing our teeth, what we do is we keep the tap open. So, जब तक हम brush करते हैं तब तक पानी जो है वो tap में से बहकर waste होता है. So, this should be prevented. Apart from that, while doing, carrying out other activities such as washing utensils, washing clothes and even while bathing, we knowingly or unknowingly waste water. So this should be prevented. Here we are told that leaking taps is another source of wastage of water which should be prevented. We have seen that most of the water that we get as rainfall just flows away. This is a waste of precious natural resource. The water can be used to recharge the groundwater. This is referred as water harvesting or rainwater harvesting, about which you have learned in class 6. Find out if the buildings in your neighborhood have water harvesting systems installed. The rainwater that falls on earth is generally allowed to flow away. However, it can be saved and used to replenish, that is, refill the groundwater levels of earth. This process of preventing rainwater from flowing away and storing it for different purposes, such as refilling groundwater levels, household chores, and industrial purposes, is called rainwater harvesting or water harvesting. You can find out on your own the buildings in your neighborhood have water harvesting systems installed or not. We have at many places in India an age-old practice of water storage and water recharge, like the bowries. Bowry was the traditional way of collecting water. With time, the bowries fell into disuse and garbage started piling in these reservoirs. However, because of the acute water shortage, people in these areas have had to rethink. The bowries are being revived. Today, the situation is that in spite of scanty rains, these places are managing their water needs well. So, an ancient practice of storing water is involved in construction of bowries. However, in time the usage declined. यानि कि लोग इनमें garbage जो है वो रखते थे या फिर इनका जो है use धीरे धीरे कम हो गया था, लोग भूल गए थे इनको use करना. But ऐसा situation आया, ऐसा shortage आया पानी का, जिस वजह से people had to rethink. They thought that why not we use it wisely. So bowries were revived, that is they again came into practice. That is, due to scanty rainfall, people are again using them to solve the problem of water shortage, and because of this, the places that are practicing still. They are using water from the bowries. They are managing their water needs properly. A farmer using water in the field can also use water economically. Maybe you have heard of drip irrigation. Drip irrigation is a technique of watering plants by making use of narrow tubings which deliver water directly at the base of the plant. Here in figure 16.9, you can see drip irrigation in a field. So it is a technique used by farmers to water their fields. Farmers have to use water, तो वो जो है wisely water को use कर सकते हैं, water को इस तरह से manage कर सकते हैं कि water भी use होगा, water पौधों को भी मिलेगा, उसके अलावा उसका wastage भी नहीं होगा. So in this, water is allowed slowly to drip into the plants so that the water directly gets into the roots of the plants. So this minimizes evaporation, saves water and allows the nutrients to reach the plant easily. Narrow tubes, as you can see here, are used to make water reach the roots of the plants in drip irrigation. What role can you play? Have you ever shown concern if you saw a tap leaking in your house, school or any other place? Leaking taps waste a lot of water. You must make efforts to stop this leakage. So just like we read earlier, we know that leaking taps are a huge source of wastage of water. So here we are asked that if you have ever seen a tap leaking in your house or your school or any other place, तो क्या आपने कुछ ऐसा किया है, क्या आपको कभी कंसर्न हुआ है कि इतना सारा पानी वेस्ट हो रहा है, तो आपने इसके लिए क्या एफर्ट्स लिए हैं. सो यू मस्ट टेक एफर्ट्स टू स्टॉप लीकेज ऑफ वाटर इफ़ इट इज़ हैपनिंग इन फ्रंट ऑफ योर आइज. यू कैन आइदर ब्रिंग इट टू द नोटिस ऑफ एन अडल्ट कि इस पर्टिकुलर जगह पे ये जो टैप है वो लीक हो रहा है, तो उसको रिपेयर कर सकते हैं, इस वजह से पानी का वेस्टेज जो है वो नहीं होगा. सो यू नीड टू फिक्स एनी वाटर टैप्स दैट आर लीकिंग इमीडिएटली. दिस इज़ वन वे ऑफ सेविंग वाटर बिकॉज लीकिंग टैप्स दे वेस्ट अ लॉट ऑफ वाटर. There are a number of ways you can adopt to minimize the wastage of water. Let us begin. We have given a few examples. Add on. Water wise habits. Turn off taps while brushing. Mop the floor instead of washing. So there can be a lot of ways to save water. We can adopt different ways to minimize the wastage of water. Yani kam se kam pani ka wastage ho. Iske liye hum kuch aadatein, habits follow kar sakte hain. Here we are given two such water wise habits. The first is you should always keep the taps closed while brushing your teeth or while washing the face in order to prevent water from flowing away unnecessarily. One should use it only when needed. Instead of washing the floor, you can mop the floor so that less water is used. And also for washing cars, you can use the water that is left from washing clothes instead of using running water. So yahan pe kuch aise water wise habits diye hue hain. You need to add on these habits in order to manage water properly. So this is a role you can play to minimize the wastage of water. Effect of water scarcity on plants. You must have seen potted plants wilting and ultimately drying up if they do not get water even for a few days. You have already learned in chapter 1 that plants need water to get nutrients from the soil to prepare their food. Just imagine the consequences if water is not available to plants. So here we are told that you must have seen potted plants wilting, मुरझा जाते हैं and ultimately drying up, सूख जाते हैं अगर उनको कुछ दिनों तक पानी नहीं मिलता है तो, right? So यहाँ पे आप imagine कर ही सकते हैं कि अगर आपके पास water नहीं होगा plants को water करने के लिए, then they will eventually dry up because we have already learned that plants need water to get nutrients from the soil in order to prepare their food. So we consume the food that is prepared by the plants. So agar plants hi nahi rahenge, then we will not have any food to consume. the green character of the planet shall be lost. This may mean the end of all life, for a world without plants shall mean no food, no oxygen, not enough rain, and innumerable other problems. So here, as we are told, imagine the consequences. आप लोग सोच सकते हो कि क्या क्या consequences हो सकते हैं अगर पानी अवेलेबल नहीं होगा प्लांट्स के लिए. जो ग्रीनरी होगी हमारे प्लैनेट में वो कम्प्लीटली लॉस्ट हो जाएगी. सो इस वजह से क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम्स आ सकते हैं, बहुत सारे अनगिनत प्रॉब्लम्स आ सकते हैं. उनमें से एक है, प्लांट्स नहीं होंगे तो खाना नहीं होगा, प्लांट्स नहीं होंगे तो ऑक्सीजन नहीं होगा, एंड वी विल नॉट इवन गेट इनफ रेन. सो दिस आर द प्रॉब्लम्स दैट वी मे फेस इफ देर इज स्कैरसिटी ऑफ वाटर. सो यू शुड नॉट वेस्ट फूड as it takes a lot of water to irrigate the fruits and vegetables. In the similar manner, you should not throw away water unnecessarily. You should use water whenever it is necessary. A successful initiative. Rajasthan is a hot and dry place. The challenge of natural scarcity of water was met by a successful experiment. A band of social workers has transformed a dry area in the Alwar district into a green place. They have revived 5 dried up rivers: Arveri, Ruparel, Sarsa, Bhagani and Jahazwali by constructing water harvesting structures. So here we are given information about a successful initiative. We all know that Rajasthan is a hot and dry place. यानी कि naturally Rajasthan में water scarcity का problem है, water shortage का problem है. तो एक successful experiments के वजह से एक कुछ social workers ने ये जो dry area है Alwar district में उसको green place में बदल दिया है. And they have revived dried up rivers such as these 5 rivers. How did they do that? By constructing water harvesting structures.